Hey YouTube, welcome back to my channel, and I'm so excited to share with you guys this new holiday makeup I just did, along with the outfit. It's that time of season where we're all going out, we're celebrating with our family, our friends, our boos. If you're interested in seeing how I got this makeup tutorial, make sure you keep watching, and let's get into the video.
So starting off with my brows, I'm just brushing them up and just filling them in with this Anastasia Beverly Hills pencil. And then I'm going to take some concealer and just make them pop with the concealer at the bottom to clean them up and just make them look a little bit more neater. So the next thing I'm doing is just taking this this blending brush and just blending out that concealer so there's no harsh lines either. So we're just blending that concealer out so it looks a little bit more natural and seamless. And quick little dance break, let's get lit. I was listening to Megan Thee Stallion, Ride or Die. That is my joint right now. And yeah, y'all know I'm a dancer, so I like to get lit. So moving on to my face, I'm taking my Baby Skin primer. And I'm just gonna focus that onto my T-zone and where I may get, so where my pores may be a little bit more noticeable. I like to use the primer to kind of camouflage that. Going on to foundation, I'm using Maybelline's Fit Me foundation. This is one of my go-to's as far as drugstore. And I'm gonna use this foundation brush and we're just gonna buff that into the skin. Okay, so next going in with the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer, we're just gonna hide those dark circles and highlight under my eyes just to give me an extra pop. Then we're gonna take the Beauty Blender and blend that out. So next going in with the Laura Mercier setting powder, we're just gonna set what we just did with that concealer because we don't want any creasing. This really sets my concealer to where it does. It stays in all day. It prevents me from being oily. And this is just one of my holy grails. It's very expensive, but it's so worth it because it makes my makeup look so seamless. So next, I'm gonna add some dimension to my face with this Anastasia Beverly Hills contour palette. And I just went in with the darkest color just to add the dimension into my face so it's just not one color. I'm really big on contouring and bronzing up the skin because it just makes it look radiant. So moving on to eyes, I'm going into this peach shade. I'm using this as a transition shade for my eyeshadow look that I'm going to be doing. And we're just going to add that to the crease. That's what I'm focusing on right now, just putting it in the crease. And then we're going to take this deeper brown and we're going to focus that on the crease as well, just darkening that transition color that we just did. And we're just gonna blend it out in the crease. Blend. That's the key to eyeshadows. Blending is the key. Like, you gotta just keep blending. It takes a while, but once you get that look, it's all worth it. Okay, so next going in with this champagne color, I'm just gonna apply that with my finger. Because I noticed when I use my finger, I can apply more of the shadow onto my lid. So we're just focusing that on lid and just pressing it lightly just to give it an extra pop. The main thing is the lid, so I just like to use my finger because I feel like I can grab more of the shadow. Okay, next I'm just gonna take some of that brown that we used previously. I'm just adding it to the bottom of my lash line, and this is just gonna complete the look, so it's just not shadow on my eyelids. It just completes it and just makes it look like a whole all around eye look. So we're just gonna add that to the bottom. So going in with my mascara, we just going to plump my lower lashes. So when I put my falsies on, it's just a little bit easier. I just love putting on mascara first and then put my lashes on. Okay, so going in with lashes, we're gonna apply the glue. This is some glue from the hair store, and it just takes a while for them to dry. So as you see, I'm just like stalling, just trying to wait. And then I finally put them on using a little handheld mirror. And this is like the best way of putting on your lashes, guys. If you have like a small mirror and you kind of hold it down, you can kind of see where the lash line is. It's so much easier to see the lash line. So I would definitely try putting them on with a smaller mirror. So I'm just waiting, listening to my music right here, getting lit. I think I was listening to Summer Walker probably. So Summer Walker always gets me in my bag, y'all. I know y'all can, a lot of y'all can relate. So I'm just waiting for the blue to dry, and this is what I did in the meantime. So going into blush, we're just gonna chisel up the cheeks a little bit and add some more color. I love blush because it makes me look so girly and dainty and cute. Next, going in with this highlighter. This is actually a Wet n Wild highlighter, and it's very close to the Becca highlighter, but it's so pigmented and I love it. And it just really gives me a nice highlight. I really love highlighting my nose because it just gives it an extra pop, but I prefer using my finger because it makes it look a little bit more natural. It actually melts into my skin really nicely and gives me like a nice little cute little button nose. So we're also going to highlight the inner corners of my eyes. My cupid's bow. And my brow bone. For me, I love to glow. I love glowing. It's my favorite thing with makeup. So highlighting is very crucial to my makeup routine, period. Period. And then we're just gonna go in with the setting spray and set all of the makeup that we just did to my face. And yeah, we're just gonna let that air dry. And then, yeah. You to take me to go shopping in Paris, I go sailing overseas and just drape me in Gucci now. All I ever asked was you to pick up the phone and you alone. All I ever asked was you to show me some kisses and hugs. Alright, so after my little Summer Walker break, I just had to go in with some Vaseline and moisturize these lips because I am putting on a lipstick. So, you know, you can't have no dry, crusty lips with matte lips. So we're just going to go in with my Fenty Beauty lip paint in red. I forget the name of it, but I'll put it in the description box. But yeah, so we're going to go in with this bold red. This is my favorite red color. It's around the holidays. And that's what's going to bring this look to life. So we're just going in with that Fenty Beauty. And we're just going to add that red lip. Because it's holiday season. Yeah. This completes the makeup look. I was really feeling myself. I loved how it turned out. And now I'm going to just show you guys my outfit. And just how I put everything together with the shoes, the accessories, and things like that. And yeah, just stay tuned and watch this next clip. Put on your red dress. And slip on your high heels. And some of that sweet perfume. It sure smells good on you. Slide on your lipstick and let all your hair down.
And when you get through,